¿no? Lo has visto durante product analysis. So, main objective of the product analysis to obtain the quality as well as the quality of evaluation of the inclusion of some of the factors to determine the preliminary the success of manufacturing the product. So the many products have to be analyzed related to the development and design factors which vary these characters and complexities and factors are related to different infinite of production and industrial engineering. Some of the factors influencing for product design can be grouped under four categories. So there are the marketing aspect and production categories. Sorry, production characteristics. So in the production categories, we have classified into functional aspect and operational aspect and durability and dependabilities and aesthetic aspects. So the economic analysis, third one is economic analysis. So in the economic analysis, the further classified that is product consideration and the effect of standardization and the simplifications and the specialization. And the last one is a break-even analysis. So fourth product is that is called as the product inspector. So in that four categories, that is we are used for the factors to be considered for the product analysis. So normally that is a marketing aspect is the first categories. So the marketing aspect is that then that based on the analysis in the market, then sent to that product of material or economic analysis, that is economic analysis. Based on the economic analysis, we have sent some of the feedback from that functional and operational and a durability analysis. Then the feedback is sent to the economic analysis. Based on the economic analysis, the, some of the sent to that product, the information is sent to that product development system. Or otherwise that product development system is also received from that research and R&D department. So based on that product development is also have sent that product designs is the third category. So in the third part of the work, based on the economic analysis is sent to the product designs. So based on the product designs is sent to that sales, that is productions and sales and advertising and further marketing research and design modification is also sent to the feedback from that after completion of the product designs. So then we have discussed about that is a marketing aspect. Then we explained that marketing aspect for we have says it is necessary to ensure that the proposed product should fulfill the demand of market, or otherwise we have says that it is very important for in the marketability of the proposed product. Marketability of the proposed product. So if there is no potential of market for the proposed product or model or proposed model, then it is a meaningless of activity for the design and manufacturing of the product. So before going to the product design or other activities, so the marketability of the product should be carefully analyzed. So the market analysis done to determine the size and the nature of the customer and present trends of the market. So it should be analysis. So the marketing analysis is for the proposed product. So I give some of the answers to the following questions. So whether that product should be offered for function or desirable or acceptable for the customers, then it is within the buying capacity of the customer that the product satisfies the customer preference for regard to the size and shape or colors. So that is a product, is the product is already is existing, then is a entirely a new product about the customer is unaware. So what will be happen, what would be expected demand for the product for both short term and long term, and what are the factors influence for the demand in this proposed product? So what are the competitors and what are the competition for the product? Then what are the distinguished feature offered by the competitor? And what is the price prevailing in the market? And what is the price distribution system? So this is for the some of the factors to be analysis to during that and questions to be raised for the market analysis. The examination of demand of the existing product. Then the demand can also be created with the introducer of the product by filling a gap or otherwise a market by offering a new features or new function likewise. So the estimation such as a demand can be accessed by the market resources. So if the management want to achieve that maximum satisfaction or otherwise decide to supply their customer with what they want or otherwise what supposed to want, what really have to produce the variety of models suit for every taste. So it should be having that essential for that one thing. So then one of the that is a main source for advertising of the product, advertising of the product. Some of the objective of the some advertising of the market, advertising to the market. So having a general information about that is existing a product or a technical information about the functional characteristics about that product. Draw the customer's attention of the product. Likewise, it should be give some of the advertisement view as a marketing aspect. Create the demand and educate to the customer. Likewise, to be give some of the awareness of marketing aspect to the customer. And similarly, it should be that is a customer should be understood clearly that the input of marketing experts deciding the produce to market or how many, how to make and when it. When to make them. So likewise, it should be analyzed in market. So the marketing aspect which analyze the factors that influence for the demand of the product during the crucial step of the product analysis. So then we have discussed about the product analysis, that is a product characteristic. So in the product characteristics, one of the aspect is the functional aspect. So one that product is a marketability, the proposed product has been explored, then the functional scope of the product has to be carefully analyzed and properly defined. If the functional analysis reveals the function of scope of the product, that is how the product it function. For example, if you are using as a washing machine, has clearly defined the objective of the to washing the clothes. You know that washing of the clothes. So, however, this does to state how the washing should be carried out, whether that is a drying or a spinning. Likewise, both are the to be done within the machine, or otherwise it should be if it portion between the automatic or manual. Likewise, that is a function analysis, obviously, influencing the design of the machine. So, it is the appearance and it prices. Nowadays, there is a trend of different functional variety of the product, increasing the range of application and product of the customers. So, for example, there is a similarly another we are using is a mixie, we are using is a mixie machine, that is a, using as a kitchen, it is a mixing machine. So, the large number of attached in a variety of these variety of machines. So basically, the mixer is using for power consists of that is a power unit and speed regulator, but it has design cover the all the attachment. So using as a household, a power tool set design which were same principle that hand drilling or basic units like this attachment to be used for this polish or cutter etc. So that will be used for these things. So in each case, each and every case, as a customer has designed, defined himself and the functional scope, so that will be satisfied his needs and taste and his ability to pay. So the variety of production and machinery may quite often to result in substantial saving for the flow space or and the capital expenditures. So this functional aspect becomes one of the fundamental factors for after the affect the design policies. So next one is have used for another operational characteristics, that is a operational aspect. One of the function is called as a operational aspect. What the functional aspect of the proposed product are determined, then we are going to that is a operational aspect of the product, carefully analyzed and properly defined. So besides that, the performing is intended the function, the product should also be easily handled and simple to operate. So the product is used to different operation condition, and the customer varies the aspect to skill with the knowledge. So the factors in addition with multifunctional features are complicated. The product design is very complicated. There is a designer problem. So the variety of equipment should be analyzed. Is this have a very light or otherwise easily handled? Particularly when the subsequent operations are carried within that aid of different attachment, the designer should always bear the mind is required for perform the changeover. Should make that a certain time which a reasonable proportion to operation of the time. Then as a durability and dependability for the next one is for the durability and dependability. So what is the durability and dependability? Has two factors for determine the quality and the reliability of the product. Hence they have to carefully consider for the product designer. So what is meant by durability means this refers to their length and activity of lifetimes or endurance of the life product under given various working condition or otherwise working operation. Likewise, it will be having that is a durability. So that is a measurement of capability to ideal withstand the storage is also often considered for assigning for the durability. So the durability is need not away for associated with the selection of good material. So therefore, addition creation to consider for the dependability. So what is the dependability means? That is a refer the reliability which is the product is serves as a intent function. So when the product does not function at a right movement, when it's called upon that is a it is a job, then very poor to or non-dependability. So other aspect of durability, so the maintenance and repairs. So the amount of repair and preventive maintenance is required for some of the product is closely related to the quality and design policy. So easily acceptability means that is a fundamental principle is sound designs or enough to knowledge of the operational durability or dependability and maintenance requirement, and the product to be absolutely essential to ensure well balanced the design within the policy outline of higher management.